A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 17th September, on the front page you have government data on Jammu and Kashmir terror justify lockdown, says Supreme Court. The Supreme Court has found the government statistics of thousands of instances of death, terror and violence in Jammu and Kashmir from 1990 as formidable reason for the August 5, 2019 lockdown that followed the withdrawal of the special rights and privileges of Kashmiri people with the reading down of Article 370. So it's been 3 months of, more than a month now since August 5, the lockdown, but the Supreme Court says that it is justified. Then this is, drone strike on Saudi facility lead to jump in crude prices. So this is regarding how the crude prices have increased because supplies to India may also be affected. But Saudi Aramco officials, the company which is the oil supplying company of Saudi Arabia, it says that its supplies will not be affected. But then there have been a steep increase in oil prices, you can see. Then below you have Farooq detained under Public Security Act. His house declared a jail. So this is former Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Farooq Abdullah. His house has been declared a jail. So there was a plea in Supreme Court initiated against his detention, and before that is heard, you can see that government has acted and declared his house a jail. And this is Ayodhya parties want to resume talks. So Ayodhya Mediation Committee filed a short memorandum informing the Supreme Court that parties across Hindu-Muslim religious divide have approached it with a request to resume talks to amicably resolve over 70-year-old Ram Janmabhoomi Babri Masjid title dispute. So mediation had been initiated, but the Supreme Court cut it short and has started hearing on the case. But now it seems that mediation is what the parties are seeking. On page 6 you have High Court stays Yogi government's move to shift 17 OBCs to SC list. So this is a major setback to Yogi Adityanath government. The Allahabad High Court has decided that has actually stayed its decision to include 17 OBCs in the SC list. So it was an apparent bid to woo the communities ahead of the bipoles. On page 9 you have Turkish award for activist who survived assault by coal mafia. So this is Meghalaya-based rights activist Agnes Kharsling, who survived an assault by a coal mafia almost a year ago. She has received international Grant Dink award along with Turkish activist. So this is the felicitation being done. On the editorial page, the first editorial is undesirable and divisive. So this is regarding Hindi language. It says promoting greater use of Hindi language is fine, but making it the language of homogenization should be best avoided, that everybody should use Hindi and, you know, in that manner. So on Hindi Divas, we saw Union Home Minister Amit Shah making a pitch for greater use of Hindi in official work. So it is in that context. Then this is avoidable boat tragedy. So this is regarding the boat which capsized in Godavari River. There were tourists going for, you know, visiting a tourist place, but then the boat resulted, a boat could not move with the overflowing water of Godavari. So Godavari has been overflowing, it has been in a state for a few days now, and still they ventured into the river, that too without government permission, is because of which the tragedy has occurred. So this editorial says, as past lessons remain unlearned, man-made tragedies recur with alarming regularity. The lead article, the slow climb to the trillion economy peak. So this article says that there has to be a focus on human capital formation and in addressing the real reasons for the economic slowdown. So the economic slowdown is evident. The government has planned to become a $5 trillion economy. So how would we reach that if we are facing this slowdown is the question. And it says, this article says that there should be focus on human capital formation, means empowering humans, making them productive. That is it. So of course that is through taking care of education, health, taking care of the agriculture sector, etc. Then this is Israel-Pakistan ties on a bridge too far. So this is regarding how Pakistan would dilute its Islamic credentials if it were to establish diplomatic ties with Israel. So Israel, India-Israel links are discussed here, and Pakistan, how it fits in is discussed. Then on the op-ed page, you have the debut of Periyar through a story. So this is regarding Periyar. The earliest reference in Tamil literature is made to E.V. Ramaswamy Iyer as Periyar. So this is regarding him. And this is Protect the Messenger. So this is regarding how regional press in India is especially vulnerable to administrative excesses, political pressure and corruption. And this is regarding history of British Indian administration made efforts to create records rather than take resolute action in Bengal famine. So this is history revisited. Then on page 12 you have Ayodhya parties want to resume talks. So this is regarding continuation of the front page news which we saw. So mediation was actually abruptly dropped in July due to resistance from certain blocs across the religious divide. But now parties want to resume talks. And below you have US President to attend Modi meet. So this is regarding Prime Minister Narendra Modi's joint appearance will take place with US President Donald Trump in September 22, Howdy Modi diaspora event in Houston in USA. So PM is delighted by Trump's decision. He says it highlights the recognition of contribution of the Indian community to America. Then on international page you have US locked and loaded after Saudi attack. So President Trump has hinted at a potential military response to the drone strikes on oil infrastructure. So this is a threat to Iran. And this is no breakthrough in Johnson's Brexit talks with election with European Commission's Juncker. So UK is yet to offer any legally operational solution on border issue. And this is 6 lakh Rohingya in Myanmar face threat of genocide. So UN mission urges UN Security Council to refer the country to International Criminal Court. So the Rohingya present in Myanmar still face serious risk of genocide. And this is Solomon Island ends ties with Taiwan. So Solomon Island's government has cut official ties with Taiwan in a new blow to President of Taiwan who is seeking re-election amid rising tensions with China. Then on business page you have Make in India, Export from Here, Prasad tells tech majors. So this is regarding Union Minister Ravishankar Prasad who has called on tech giant Apple to create a robust presence in India. So you have Make in India and Export from India. So bid for that is made. And this is Digital Certificate of Origin System unveiled. So, Commerce Minister Piyush Goyal has announced to revive the export sector through launching this common digital platform for the issuance of certificates of origin, and also steel import monitoring system has been launched. So, that is it. The last page then has sports news. So, these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, ashr.com. Thank you.